Hey, ready? See that formula behind me? I'll duck. It says degrees Celsius times 1.8 plus 32 equals Fahrenheit. Let's sing it together. Degrees Celsius times 1.8 plus 32 equals Fahrenheit. Good. You're going to need to know it in a minute. All right. The easiest and probably best way, I guess, to take relative humidity is to use one of these things. This thing is called a Sling Cyclometer. And if you look at it, you can tell that there are two thermometers on the Sling Cyclometer. One of the thermometers, this top one in this case, is called the dry bulb, like dry. This bottom one is called the wet bulb, like wet. Okay? What you do is this. You take that part that has the little bit of cotton on it, take a little glass of water, you dip the cotton in. Can't see me doing it, but there you go. Dipping the cotton into the water. Very good. Now that cotton is wet. You don't want to get the other bulb, the dry bulb, wet. Just the wet bulb gets wet, the dry bulb stays dry. And what you're going to do is you're going to sling this like this. I don't want to break it, but this is a professional model. I'm a professional. Okay? You sling it for about a minute. And what's going to happen is this. The dry bulb gives you the air temperature. The wet bulb does this. Because the bulb is wet, because I just dipped that cotton into water, the water is going to evaporate into the atmosphere. And as the water evaporates, evaporation is a cooling process. The result is going to be that the wet bulb, this one with the water on it, is going to register a lower temperature than the dry bulb, which is giving you air temperature. The difference between those things is called the wet bulb depression, or the depression of the wet bulb. So, for example, if the dry bulb said it was 60 degrees and the wet bulb said it was 50 degrees, the difference between them is 10. That would be the wet bulb depression. Okay? Again, if you take a look at lab five and you flip to page 13, lucky number 13, exercise 5.5, I will read part of it. Use the Sling psychrometers found in the front of the classroom and the psychrometric table found in table four. Table four is this crazy, wacky thing right there. On the previous page to complete the box below. It's more accurate than tables 3A and 3B since the air temperature intervals are every 1 degree rather than every 5 degrees. Take the temperature readings inside the classroom and outside the classroom. I'm going to do that right now. I'm going to do inside, then I'm going to go outside and set up and do it outside also. Then you are going to record it on this table here. And when you do that, of course, there's going to be questions on the quiz about it. Here we go. Because you can't do it with me in the classroom because we are not in the classroom together, just virtually in the classroom. So I'm going to use the one that you would actually use. Since you guys are students, you would be using the student model. All right? Cheaper. That's what it comes down to. $4. That other one, 125. So you can see that there's a little bit of cotton wrapped around this thermometer right here. I'm going to dip that into water. Look, here we go. Whoop, there it goes. At the same time, this one over here does not have cotton on it. This is the dry bulb. This will give you air temperature. This is the wet bulb. This will give you the depression. It's going to be a lower temperature. However, notice yours are Celsius. And the answers need to be in Fahrenheit, which is why degrees Celsius times 1.8 plus 32 equals Fahrenheit. So when we get the numbers for this, you record them, and at the same time, you're going to have to convert them into Fahrenheit in order to be able to complete this correctly. Okay? So here we go. I'll dip this in again to make sure that nothing got away. And then what I'm going to do is this. I'm going to do what you guys would have been doing if you were in here, okay? Which is I'm going to sling this thing for 1 minute. So I have to do this for 1 minute. Let me watch the clock. All right? Da-da-da. Da-da-da. Did I tell you the mushroom joke yet? I know if you're in the class, you've probably heard it before. I don't know that many jokes. What am I going to do? So here's a mushroom joke. A mushroom walks into the bar and walks up, leans on the bar, and says to the bartender, "Bartender, give me a beer." The bartender looks over at the mushroom and says, "Mushroom, what are you doing in here? We don't serve your kind in here." And the mushroom looks over and says, "Why not? I'm a fun guy." Tell that one to mom. Huh? All right, a couple more seconds. Nice. All right. Let's see what we got. So first, let's take a look at the dry bulb. You can see the dry bulb right there. See what that temperature is? Whoops, right. There we go. What would you say that is? It's not 35. Okay, that's not what it is. And then take a look right here. Can you see the way the light bulb? It's a lower temperature. Look at that. Remember, these are in Celsius. Okay, so what do you see there? Write them down and record them. There it is. That's the wet bulb. This is the dry bulb. Okay? Good. Now what you do is on this paper, this is indoors. I personally would write the Celsius here and here for dry bulb and wet bulb. Convert that to Fahrenheit using the formula behind me. And then write depression of wet bulb thermometer. That's the difference between these two. Okay, in Fahrenheit. And then you come over here and you look up at the top. It says dry bulb in Fahrenheit. So you find the temperature across here with the dry bulb. And then over on the other side, it says wet bulb on both sides. And then you just find where these two things come together. And wherever they come together, that will tell you what the relative humidity in this classroom is right now. Cool. All right. Looking forward to seeing your answer.